Hey everyone, welcome to today's video walkthrough for the podcast, privatelabelpodcast.com. Make sure you go and listen to today's episode because it's going to go into a lot more detail about the ways in which we remove seller feedback, negative seller feedback, and give you some ideas of different reasons that we may want to do that as well. Today, I'm just going to simply walk you through the steps that we talked about in the podcast. You can also find a downloadable PDF companion guide exclusively yours at privatelabelpodcast.com. Hey, do you have an idea for an upcoming Listen and Learn episode? Make sure you let us know that. You can do that on Facebook at the Private Label Empire Builders Group or through the contact form or the comments on today's show notes section. All right, so to remove negative seller feedback, here I am in my Seller Central account. I'm going to simply click over here to the left where it says customer feedback, 4.9 stars over the past 12 months. I'm going to click on that. And at the very top here, I've got one that we need to remove. So this is a feedback that came in just a few days ago about a product that I've had quite a lot of problems with the fulfillment angle. That's a whole nother story for us to get into, but bottom line is here's someone that has left a product review in the form of seller feedback. They're talking about the product being overpriced, it wasn't loud enough for what they wanted, etc. So all I'm going to do is copy this order number. And I'm going to scroll down to the bottom and click on Get Support. And then when the support screen opens up, I'm going to select Contact Us. It's going to take me to the Contact section. I'm going to click Selling on Amazon and then Customers and Orders. Here I'm going to paste in the order that we just copied. I'm going to click Next. It's going to say, what can we help you with? And I'm going to select Customer Feedback Removal Request and then Next. And here it's showing me the feedback that the customer left. Again, they're saying they were very disappointed. I'm going to click Next. And what the system is going to do is it's going to scan that customer's feedback. And it's looking for certain keywords. And in this case, it's saying right down here, you can see, thank you for submitting this request to remove the feedback. We would like to inform you that the feedback submitted for review was in violation of our feedback guidelines. Therefore, we have removed the inappropriate entity. So it's as simple as that. It took me, about a minute and a half probably to do that whole process. And let's talk again briefly about why Amazon removed it. Amazon removed it because it was a product review that was left in the form of seller feedback. They will also either remove or strike through feedback if the buyer is talking about shipping, if there's a problem with shipping, or if the box arrived damaged, things like that. And the reason is because we sell items FBA or fulfilled by Amazon. So there you have it. It's a very simple process. I remove anything that's 3 stars or lower because that's the threshold of what Amazon considers negative feedback. Hey, we'll see you guys next week. Thanks a lot and happy selling.